Hey guys, welcome back. Since I got so many questions, I wanted to guide you through an easier and safer experience to jailbreak your PS3. The first thing you have to know is that you are gonna use alternative mirrors to be able to jailbreak your PS3 at the moment. This is because PS3 exploit is currently down and it has been flagged. So what does that mean? It means that the website will be back under a new name, probably sometime in the future, and it will bring back BGTOOLSET 2. So if you wanna stay updated on the situation, you can follow the thread I linked in the description below. Now before we start, I'll quickly explain you the difference between OFW, CFW and HFW. So I'll make sure you clearly understand the difference. So, OFW basically means original firmware, which is the firmware that Sony provides your PlayStation with. And you want to update this to the latest version for this guide, which is 4.89. While HFW means homebrew firmware, which is something in between a OFW and a CFW, but is not to be confused with a full custom firmware. So the homebrew firmware will still let you run homebrews, but is not a complete jailbreak. So for the full experience, I really recommend jailbreaking your console with a custom firmware, which will be seen in this tutorial. For any of you that still wants to homebrew firmware, I will leave you an alternative mirror below for the time being while PS3 exploit is down. So, as I've seen some people having trouble jailbreaking, I have made a list of requirements for you to go through the jailbreak smoothly and without problem. The first thing you want to do is unplug your controller USB from the PS3. The second thing you want to make sure is that you have a USB 2.0 formatted in FAT32, otherwise your PS3 won't recognize the update. This information is both valid for original firmware and custom firmware. The last important information I can give you is to plug your USB to the first slot of the PS3. So if you have a PS3 FAT, just continue with the tutorial. If you have a PS3 Slim, check if your code, if your console code is compatible in the compatibility list I left in the description below. If you have a Super Slim, your only option is to install PS3N, which is the homebrew firmware, which is not covered in this video. So if anything has been clear for you to this point, you can now proceed to update your PlayStation to the latest firmware, and we can start with simple and quick step to custom firmware your PlayStation 3. So you can update your PS3 by downloading the firmware in the description below or by connecting it to the internet. So once you're ready, it is now best practice to create a new user on your PS3 and from here open your browser. In the browser, to avoid any issue with the toolset, you might want to enable JavaScript, delete cookies, and delete cache. Once you are done, you are going to open one of the two alternative BGTOOLSET mirror on your PS3. Once you get on the page of the toolset, you will need to wait until the process is finished, and you will see it on the top right corner of the screen. Once it is fully done, your PS3 will emit some beeps. Once the process is complete, you can now move to the Flash Manager tab and you will see if your console is custom firmware compatible. So we are going to wait for the process to complete once we click on the System or Flash Manager. And once it is done, you will see if your PS3 is actually compatible, and if it is not, just do not continue. And if you get a green check mark, you can go on. You can also choose to save a flash memory backup in case anything goes wrong with the custom firmware. Now we have to patch our PlayStation to be able to install the custom firmware, so you can either download the patch file and then load it, like I'm doing, or you can do load from HTTPS. I just prefer to download it before patching. Of course, loading it directly from HTTPS is faster, but I want to be extra sure that the file is not corrupted, so I just go on and download it before patching it. So once it's downloaded, you can do load patch from file. So I'm gonna choose the file now I downloaded, and it's gonna be in my USB, and it will be called something like NoFSM patch. If you did HTTPS, it should be already loaded, so you can continue from the step we are going to do now. So independently, if you choose one of the other, if you go back on flash memory patch now and click again, you should see apply loaded patch. Once you feel ready, go for it, and we will now be asked if we want to continue, and I'm just going to do yes, and it's now applying the patch. If anything went right, you will now be asked to reboot your console, and from here you will be able to install the custom firmware you can find in the download in the description below. So once you downloaded it, you will need to extract it with a RAR extractor, such as WinRAR for Windows or any other software you could use on your operating system. So just move the entire PS3 folder to the USB and you should be done. Now you will need to plug it on your PS3 in the first slot. And then you can go to the normal system update and update via storage, and you will see for 89 Evilnat. And now you just wait for the usual process to finish. Meanwhile it installs, I want to tell you that if you see your PlayStation start up slowly and you see a yellow LED, it is normal, it will bring at least 3 times yellow, it is because the Evilnat is starting. So no worry and don't panic. In some cases your PS3 may turn into a turbojet and it will go full fan speed, but this is still normal. Now, if you've done everything correctly, you will see the PlayStation 3 folder. This is the folder in which your games will be loaded. So if you click it now, it will do nothing and it will throw you an error. But if you load a game, you can start a game from here. So congratulations, at this point we have a jailbreak PS3 and you can now install any manager you want. I don't recommend using Multiman, but if you want to, you can go on and use Multiman or use any other updated manager. So have fun. Thank you for watching, subscribe, leave a like, and leave a comment. Bye!